Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. With the music of awesomeness playing all around. I think this is the same lady I talked to. I just don't want to miss anybody, but we're about to head down to the cellar. Even though we were told not to. Yeah, she's the farmer's... Oh, it's Clementine. Yeah, not the same Clementine from Telltale Walking Dead. She told us not to go down there, and now we're going down there. Oh. So it's 3D. I mean, 2D. Is that that dangerous magician? As you enter the dark cellar room through the gate, you sense an imperceptible movement somewhere above you. You look up exactly at the same moment as the first of the large spiders drops down onto you. Big spiders. Okay, we've fought these before. Nothing, that difficult. Unfortunately, we're not full on strength. But I think we'll be able to handle them as long as our robe doesn't break. 6 points of damage on that one. Oh, right, we're wearing the leather. I think if they break the leather, I might just go back to the robe. I try not to cheese it too much, you know. Hopefully, like, the robe is fragile. Hopefully, like, they can't damage the leather. That's what I'm hoping. Or at least they have a very much smaller chance of doing so. And I get one damage on me from one of those. I'm failing left and right. Another one damage. Come on! Nah! Come on, I got three more to go after this one. Another 1 point. I'm gonna reduce the amount of attacks on me by killing one. Doesn't seem to be happening. Damn. Nice. Poof. I'm gonna attack this one. You know, maybe I should save that one for last, because when it retreats, it goes a square each, right? So then I could still hit it if it starts retreating. I wasn't paying attention. I don't know if I damaged it, though. We'll do that next time. I don't know why I did that. I was already attacking it. War points. Glad I had this short sword. Another one damage on me. Six points, you're gone, right? Yes. Halfway there. Hopefully I have better luck with the hits now. 4 points. Six. Nice. So maybe they have 10 points each? 10, 9, 10, something like that. It might be random amount of points. Also, they might not all just have, you know, 10 points each. Not sure. Next points. One more hit, we'll do it. Unless I just hit for one. Ah! Now it's retreating. It might come back. Nope. I still get experience, though. In the cell, you see a man clothed in rags, wandering up and down restlessly. Suddenly, a little mouse runs into his cell. When the man notices it, his eyes take on a strange, threatening glow. suddenly raises his arms and a flash of light turns the mouse into a pile of dust. The man lowers his arms and continues his restless wandering. Before I go any further, because I don't want to die and have to fight that again or lose those 10 experience, 80 experience points. I did save that, right? Yeah. Can I talk to him through the bars? I can't look at him. I can't. Oh. Madman. Okay. So he's age 40. I don't know his name, but yet somehow I know he's a 35th level mage. Pretty awesome. Aha! Visitors to my modest hut! Haha! You came to destroy me, didn't you? Never. Haha. Hehe. Disappear before I turn you into ash. Haha. Yes, ash. Go away, go away. Ha ha ha. Hello? You know anything about hello? Daughter? Thieves Guild. Let's see if he knows anything about anything. Bandits. Cellar. Oh, Madman. Oh. Sabine? Sandra? You know anything about these people? Haha! Yes, just run away. I will still reach you with my power. Yes, reach. Only I never reached. Haha, hi. What is he saying again? Visitor. Hut. Let's try that. I don't know what you're talking about. What about the mouse? Was it a mouse or a rat? I think it was a mouse. Try rat in case it was a rat. I remembered it wrong. Alright, never mind. The only thing he was talking about was power. Nope, alright, never mind. There's nothing really we can talk to you about. What is this? As you start to work on the door, the man in the cell stands still and looks at you with shining eyes. I would never try to do this, like, legitimately. I probably can't open it. Of course, he's hoping I can pick the lock. Lock pick breaks. So I'm not sure. But we have this, right? Which unable to pick the lock. I don't know if that automatically uses the lock picks. I think that's without lock picks, because they don't break unless you actually go like this and try to use them. This item doesn't open the door. Interesting, and we can try different things. We can even try a potion. It lets us try. Alright, let's load it. Oh, I didn't even. I was just moving this way. Oh, never mind. I thought I was, but I wasn't. Alright, so that's enough for the madman. See you later. Was this a huge log? Citrine unlocks a chest using the lockpick. What do we have? BOS amulet, a broken robe, and a cell key. Well, I can't take that. Okay, that was a sneeze. Broken robe, but it's 6. This is 4, so it's really... And that's 5. It's broken, though. Key. BOS amulet. Normal item. I wonder what that is. BOS. Well, I'll hold on to it for sure. Saving. That's probably his cell key. Most probably not canon, guys. Citrine has unlocked the door. You do not enter the cell immediately, and you hesitate for a good reason. Hardly have you entered the cell when the strange man utters a terrible scream and raises his arms up high to destroy you with his magic flash of light. Oh. Well. Defend. He's gonna kill me immediately. Dark mage moves. I don't think I could win this battle. I really sincerely doubt it. Goodbye. If I was at full, I could have withstood that. One hit, but yeah. Never mind, I have his cell key and I'm leaving. Is she gonna realize that I did that? Wait a second. Too late. Oh, the torn but costly robe. I need to go back for that. I'll be back when I can carry his robe. If we could just fast travel back here. I think... In case that's a bandit over there, we should probably heal a little bit. Oh wait, I can stay in there for... I might just be the old man, but... Where's the door? No, it's down this place. We can stay here for just 5 gold pieces. I wish you a good night's stay. Why, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, that's the... Where are we? I need to leave this place. Have I been in here? Oh yeah, that's the... I was going for the books again. You can't look at those books. I have talked to you, yes, just being thorough. Yep, try to bash your head in. Sounds like a rollicking good time. So now that we're at full, still exploring this place, Spannenberg. Oh, we've been over there. That's the healer. Cemetery. We need to go back the other way, but I want to see if that's a bandit there. I want to get rid of all these bandits. Oh. Oh my, what'd it say? Ah. Something about figures. I couldn't read it. You guys can pause the video, go back. I was advancing forward. I didn't expect someone to jump out. I have something to defend. They flank you, I don't like that. I did 2 points of damage. And then 3. He's moving closer. They'll move as fast as the spiders at least. Maybe I'll get rid of this bandit, nope. One of them's retreating? I don't know. Oh, he retreated off into his own line. I like that. I got them both attacking me. I need to take this guy out. At least I'm attacking first. One point of damage on me. I hope these bandits are like... you know, don't respawn constantly, and that's just to set them out, and I kill them. 2 points. I need to find the general store. 3 points. Yay! 1 down, 1 to go. Geez, when you swipe so slow like that, no wonder I'm evading it. I guess I have pretty decent... the leather is pretty decent, even the robe. And I have a decent weapon for my level anyway. 2 points on him. 4 points. 2 points. Poof. The thing that stinks is I can't pick these up. Level 4. 28 points. 28 power points. Spell learning points. 19. Training points. 20. Hooray. I don't know. I mean, the only thing I could really drop, I'm not dropping money, that's for sure. I could drop rations to to trade and get some of these leathers. I have some daggers already. Yeah, I'm full. Hopefully I can actually take the gold. Yeah. I can't even take all the rations. I'm completely full now. What's this again? Have I been here? Baron George, Squire of Spannenberg. No vicious dogs or junk mail, please. Squire. Baron George. Yeah, I'm missing out on selling those leathers. It could give me a few gold. House of the Baron. Cool, more music, new tune. Oh wow. Look at that. Does he worship... Hold on. Does he worship a dragon or something? This music is awesome. I don't know what this stuff is. This is like a... some kind of crazy armoire or something. This looks like some kind of futuristic sink or something. Well, this is some huge chamber. Looks like a bat. So where is this Baron? He's asleep. We're gonna take a look around his house. I don't know why he wouldn't lock the place up. A spot of tea. His music is like epic all over the place. One ration. We can't even pick it up. Baron, you want to buy some stuff off me? I realize I'm not really saving much because nothing was accomplished. Wakey wakey. Should I wait? We don't have a clock to look at to see the time pass. Oh wait, I just let go and it said how many hours. He left me in his room. Greetings! An old cook looks at you and says, oh, this isn't the Baron. You are hungry, aren't you? Go into the kitchen and have something to eat. If you are interested in strange stories, ask Lady Heidi again about the fairies. She told me this story a few days ago, and the Baron says she only dreamed it. But I believe the lady. Okay. I'm looking for the Baron and the lady. Hello! You see a lady wearing a robe of costly brocade and silk. She smiles at you. So already you see how much... This is like a lot of... stuff. A lot of things are going on here. And this is bound to be a very long game. Significantly longer than Amberstar, I think. This game is distributed on 9 floppy disks. Believe it or not. 9. She's an adventurer one. The guy started out. Age 34. I am Lady Heidi, and I welcome you to Spannenberg. If you are looking for something to do, you should go and talk to my husband. He needs a few brave adventurers at the moment. Baron. You don't know what you're talking about. Your husband, lady. I meant to hit that, really. Do you know Sandra? Or Sabine? It doesn't appear like anything. She had something... Fairies? Ah! My husband feels I dreamed the whole thing, but as you're interested in the story, I am pleased to tell you about it. A few days ago, I was unable to sleep at night, so I got up and looked through the window at the two moons. Sometime later, I suddenly saw a strange apparition. Several unusual beings came flying towards the house. At first, I thought they were angels, but when they came quite close, I could see that they were women. The strange thing about them, however, was that their skin was blue and green, and they had large shimmering wings. Although I personally locked the front door that evening, not like last night, because I just walked in. A few moments later, they were simply standing in the entrance hall. I hid and watched them. They behaved like small children, they laughed quietly, and looked at everything with great interest. Above all, they seemed to be fascinated with things that glistened or shone. I saw them take several silver spoons from the dining room. Then, in the conference chamber, they found my husband's chain of office, and one of the green-skinned beings hid it away. Shortly afterwards, they left the house again. I quickly put a coat on and followed them, as well as I could, to the entrance of a cave to the west of here, close to where the pond lies at the foot of the small volcano. If they had flown directly there, I would never have been able to follow them that far, but, as I said, they behaved like children even while they were flying. Alright, I'm writing this down about where this cave is. I'm just writing fairies with a question mark. Lady Heidi at Baron's house, whatever. Alright, cave west of Spannenberg, where pond lies at foot of small volcano. At foot of small volcano. Took took Badge of Office, so naturally she wants that back. And he wants that back, I'm sure. When they landed, one of them took something out of a hole in a tree next to the entrance to the cave, just like you might take the key to your house out from under a plant pot. But I did not follow them into the cave because I was afraid. I returned to Spannenberg. Okay. Key. Key and tree next to cave entrance? Question mark? In the morning, I told my husband everything, but he thought I only dreamed it and that the chain of office had been stolen by the strange bandits. Wow. Quite a story. Here's the, okay. So yeah, it was a hidden word. Cool. Anything else? Cave. How about... Did she say it was a chain of office or badge of office? I think she said chain, actually. I tend to think it was a badge, but here might be a chain. Either way, she doesn't know what I'm talking about. Volcano, no. Okay. I hope you enjoy your stay in Spannenberg, even if it could become a little difficult with the many attacks by the bandits. Yeah, I'm enjoying fighting the bandits, don't worry about that. You see a tall, aristocratic-looking man in middle age. He looks at you with curiosity. The Baron, I presume? Baron George, age 36, 10th level warrior. I am Baron George, Shield von Spannenberg, and I welcome you to my town. Perhaps you can help me with one of my problems? You won't regret it. Hello. We don't start with hello in all those times, okay? Problems? Well, yes. At the moment, I have two problems here in Spannenberg. The first one involves orcs attacking my farmers. You've heard about that. They suddenly come out of the mountains to the west and plunder the fields and the farms. Yeah, mountains to the west. If you could stop their attacks or something like that and bring me proof that you have done it, I will reward you generously. Furthermore, the town is plagued by a gang of bandits. Their leader is said to be a man called Silverhand. All these years I heard a good arrangement, a good relationship with the Guild of Thieves. Okay. So I'm going to remember this name. Silverhand. Leader of Bandits. I had a good relationship with the Guild of Thieves in Spannenberg. Their members are well disciplined, at least according to their own rules, and they only stole absolute necessities, so to speak. The citizens in the town were certainly able to put up with them, although the masters of the guild promised me that they have nothing to do with the... Nothing to do with the plague? A plague of bandits, I guess, not an actual plague. They had nothing to do with the plague at this time. I cannot quite believe them, and the people living here are now rather upset. Perhaps you can shed some light on the matter. Alright. Bandits? You know anything special about bandits? That's one of your problems. Fairies? Oh, you already heard the story about my wife. I'm absolutely convinced that she only dreamed the whole thing. Whoever stole my chain of office... There was certainly no blue and green fairies. Okay, I wrote badge, I think. It is chain of office. Took... Chain of office. And talking about the chain of office, if you find it, I would have a princely reward for you. Sounds good to me. I like princely rewards. I like kingly rewards even better. Madman. Do you know Sabine? Do you know Sandra? And the Thieves Guild. What are you talking about? You don't know anything about them. I'm just discussing them. Alright. What's her name? Heidi? Whoop. I think that's her right. Lady Heidi. Alright. Chain? No. Alright. Orcs. No. I hope that you are lucky and can help me with my problems. Of course you do. Okay, I think I've been all over here. Just didn't talk to these people. What is this huge area? I wish I could ask him about this, with the dragons and everything. It's pretty interesting. I didn't mean to leave just then. Although most probably there's nothing else to see. Are you the, you look just like me, I guess. What's the cook? Alright, so you've got the cook, Lady Heidi, and the Baron, and it's the only people here, I guess. It's pretty awesome. It's gotta be something about this, though. I don't know. Oh, there's two people here. Who are these people? You're the Baron. And then who are you? Oh, Lady Heidi. You look like a Lady Heidi. Alright. Alright, we're out of here then. Wow, out of time already? Damn. Baron George. I need to see what's ahead in front of me as well. Well, that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Hello, old man. Yeah. I talked to him before. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure. Shoo, shoo, go away. Thank you.